What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com and I am back once again with another awesome Python tutorial. Today's video is about string method starts with of Python. Though there are various string methods available in Python, but for now we will stick to those that will be used most often in the upcoming tutorials. Rest of them we will discuss as and when the need arises. So without further ado, let's start with the most commonly used method for simple search in Python, which is starts with. But before that, please do not leave without pressing that thumbs up button if you like the video. Also, this year I am aiming for 1 lakh subscribers, so please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Now let's start. Right on your screen is the syntax of the starts with string method. The function begins with the phrase starts with. It accepts 3 arguments. The first argument is a search string. This is the string which you want to search. The second argument is an integer value, which indicates the index number from where the interpreter will start the search of the search string. The third argument is again an integer value, which tells the index number where the interpreter stops the search. Except from the first argument, which is search string, all other arguments are optional. In case if you do not specify the starting index value, the interpreter will start the search from the index 0. Also, if you do not specify the ending index value, the interpreter will keep searching until the string ends. So, what will the string method starts with of Python returns as an output? The function starts with returns true if it finds the search string on the specified position. Otherwise, it returns false. Now, let's do an example and learn how to use a string method starts with in Python. We need a base string over which we will perform the search. This could be a single line string or a multi-line string. For the demonstration, let's use a single line string, which will be I'm learning Python from RebellionWriter.com. There are 2 ways of using this string with the string method starts with. The first way is to store this string into a variable, and the second way is to use this string just as it is looking to you right now. I would suggest you to go with the first method, as the second will become a bit confusing. So let's create a variable and store it into that. Here I created a variable and named it base underscore string. And using the assignment operator, I stored our string into it. By the way, I will be doing a dedicated tutorial on variables in Python very soon, so don't worry about that. Let's say we want to check if our string starts with the word Python or not. For that, we will need to call the string method starts with. To call this method, we will require 2 things. First is the variable which is holding the string. And second is the starts with method itself. Let's learn how to properly use this string method in Python programming. To call the function, we first need to write the name of the variable which is holding the string. In our case, that variable is base underscore string. Followed by that, we have the dot operator. And then the name of the function starts with the parameters. Here, as parameter, we only specified the string and we did not specify any starting and ending index, which means the interpreter starts the search from index 0. If it finds the search string there, then it will return true, otherwise false. Now let's execute and see the output. Output is false, because the base string onto which the search is performed is not starting with the word Python. Let's do another example of a string method starts with. We will be doing the same demonstration, but this time we will be using the second parameter, which is starting index. Let's say I don't want the interpreter to start the search from index 0. Instead, I want it to start the search from index 14. In that case, I can specify 14 as our starting index. Let's do that. Here, I added the value for starting index in function call. When interpreter finds the value of starting index, then it commences the search from that index number. Anything before that will be skipped. Let's see the output. This time, the result is true. Now, let's say I don't want the interpreter to search the entire string. That is mere waste of time and expensive resources. I want it to search the string from index number 14 to 18. Let's see if we have our search string Python there or not. Let's execute and see the output. Oops, the output is false. This is because finding the string doesn't mean finding its part in the base string. The interpreter will return true only if it finds the exact same search string. And when I say exact, I mean every single character of the search string must match. In this case, when we specified 14 as a starting index and 18 as ending index, then the interpreter did not find the complete search string, which in this case is Python. Hence, it returned false. I have also done a detailed blog on the same topic. In that blog, I have explained all the restrictions, common errors, and their solutions, and more. Please check that out. Link is in the description. That's it for today. Please hit the thumbs up button and share the video with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.